Okay, so I know you're not normally in this class, but what do you think modern media is like on a daily basis?
I think modern media is about coming up with videos about the school and other things and interviewing students and editing them to make actual videos.
It's a pretty nice class, and you get to make videos and just have fun, and it's not really that hard, anyways.
Probably a bunch of running around trying to get kids out of the way to shoot a video.
I would say that the modern media class is about film and editing films.
Stuff to do with like media, probably, obviously cameras.
And it's really complicated and really annoying because you have so many videos you have to do. That's what I think modern media is.
Modern media is less complicated than people think it is. Some people say it's boring, some say it's uninteresting, and some think it's a waste of an elective. Despite all that, the class is truly something different. Modern media is a path to many careers. It's a way to make new friends, and most importantly, it's a way to show off your true potential. Making videos in the class are never easy, but the concept of them comes from one place and one place only, our minds. At the beginning of every new project, the ones, freshmen who take the class, embark on, it always starts around the table where ideas for their speaks and spotlight episodes are planned out. It's like Knights of the Round Table, except it has high schoolers and laptops.
So I'm doing the Sandborn update, which is the desk segment, which tells you about the news that's going around Sandborn, and it like transitions into the speaks. Spotlight.
Pretty much a speaks is like the overall topic of what you're doing, and then a spotlight is just zooming in on one specific thing.
Me and Aiden are working on a modern media winter carnival activities and sports. Just gonna make a video on like what kind of activities are going on in winter carnival. We just like put the story panels on and just like put like what videos we're having first and everything, and then the materials we need.
Scheduling an interview is way easier than you think. You simply grab your Chromebook, log on to the nearest computer, open Gmail, email who you're going to interview with time and date in mind, wait a day or two, and then see what they have to say, then work it out from there. Like every normal person, you can't know everything first go, interviews especially. Whether it's a camera person making a simple mistake, someone experienced messing up a line, or the person being interviewed themselves causing quite a ruckus, interviews in modern media are never easy.
And someone's doing...
I can speak for myself,
Jen. Alright, so what do you think the modern media class is about? Are they staged? Can you guys not for 5 minutes?
I prepare for winter carnival by going to Walmart and getting a bunch of crap to put on my body. That's the color for your grade. So say seniors are black. Guess what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna get some black clothes, some black beads, and some black headbands.
What's that to do with the gold mice?
You know it's recording, right? Like that one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a question.
Alright, what is
it? Black socks.
Oh, what events and activities happen during the
So, during the week of the carnival, there's spirit days also.
I can't do this. This is so hard. I can't do this with her here.
And some black bracelet.
We're watching the gold medals.
Yes, I'm having more.
Anyone in modern media filming a scene for their video always needs an extra hand, which is why Jackson decided to ask me for help in filming his video.
Alright Jackson, what are you planning to film today?
So we're just gonna take this like rolling camera thing, and Aiden's just gonna be sitting over there and was at a soccer ball, and he's gonna ask for a softball or something. I'm just gonna throw it at him. Just hit him in the face and he's gonna fall down.
After a few takes, we got what we needed and returned back to the room where the footage was imported. Most of the time, the room itself is filled with chatter and sounds of mice and keyboards as students are hard at work on their videos. It's not uncommon for the room to be quiet as well, but Mr. Gray can describe the environment better than I can.
I'd say controlled chaos. There's a lot that needs to go into these different productions. Timeliness is extremely important, so we're always trying to run around and find the different things we need for the news stories. Students are independently doing a lot of work and then also working within groups, so there's a lot of movement in the class. And so we're not really a sit down and kind of get things done class. We're moving and grinding and trying to get that assignment out.
A video isn't quite complete without a green screen. Using one of these is essential for making a project and can be the difference in a clean and smooth product or a clunky and finished one.
So you're about to do your green screen. What's it like?
So there's the script over there, and I'm gonna be basically reading the script in front of the camera.
Like, thanks for
signing,
like...
Am I doing MPEG or...
Producing is the next step in completing the video, and it's arguably the easiest. All you do is click on the required video format, wait out its loading time as it produces, and log in and upload the video onto YouTube where it will be viewed by the class and the world.
So not just each individual piece.
At the end of every unit, students normally sit around tables with their friends and watch everyone's finished products. Another just as important task for them is to grade their friends' videos on a rubric. This is known as peer editing, and Ms. Harwell explains how this is important as a whole.
So before our students hand in their assignments, it's really important that they go through their webisodes together as a group and that they are able to look for any mistakes that they made and give each other critiques on how they can make them better, because the group's collaboration is really important. Afterwards, it's important that students are able to give each other feedback. Feedback is really important in our process because they always have the chance for reassessment, as well as it's really important project for them to know what they can work on to be better.
Now that the groups have finished their peer edits and grading, students can now be placed into their new groups to repeat the process once more. There, they discuss what to do, what new ideas they'll use for Sanborn Spotlight to speak, who plans what, and when they'll begin filming once again. While the entire production timeline seems repetitive, making groups, selecting and arranging interviews, filming, editing, and finally producing videos to send out to the world, it's nothing more than an average news cycle for them. New stories come in and out week by week, and what's on the table is what you have to work with as a student, give or take. The class isn't just an opportunity to make videos that no one else in the school can make. It's a chance to change your life, and a chance to simply be. Behind the lens.
You gotten yet?
No.
You sure?
Yeah.
Alright, let me check here real fast. Okay, they're not gone yet. Roll credits, roll credits!